Professor Sazama, welcome to the 6th Islamic Economics Workshop, which is being held by ICAM.
Thank you.
We thought it would be a good opportunity to benefit from your presence here. So if you could, in short, explain us what is Islamic economics and how is it different from the conventional one?
Yes, well, very briefly, capitalism is based on the idea of profits that and continuous growth. And this is not compatible with a finite planet. So today we have massive over-exploitation. The situation is not sustainable. If the growth continues at this present rate, the planet's ecological environment will be completely destroyed and it will not become habitable for humanity. So Islam has a very radically different approach. First of all, it doesn't ask us to keep increasing our standard of living. It says that we should maintain a simple standard of life, and this is urgently needed because the resources being consumed at too fast a rate for renewal. And then also it says that you shouldn't go after profits. You should go after a sustainable lifestyle. So the difference between Islam and the concepts which are foundations for Islamic society is, and capitalism is very radical, and it provides an alternative in which it cannot be that the 50 people have all the more than half of the wealth and there are billions of people living under a dollar. Islam asks for equity. Islam asks for circulation of wealth. Islam says that the powerful have the duty to help the weak, and those who are wealthy must use their wealth to help the poor, not to further exploit. So see, these are some of the fundamental
differences. I understand. And if I can just shortly ask you, since the topic of the workshop is methodology of Islamic economics, and we have seen that some of the economists, Islamic economists, they are even critical of the debate on whether there should be a debate on methodology or not. Like, if it's even requisite or not. So what do you think?
Absolutely. There is a massive difference. Western methodology is based on looking at the external and the objective world. Islamic methodology is based in looking at the world inside the human heart. So it is based on a correct analysis of human behavior as opposed to standard economics, which is based on an incorrect analysis, because homo economicus is the assumption that they use about human behavior, which is completely wrong. Islam offers a much more sophisticated and complex model of human behavior.
And just the last question in this short little time. We have seen your work on axiomatization of economics, and you have done some critique over it.
Yes.
Even axiomatization of conventional economics.
Yes.
So if you could briefly tell us why the axiomatization is wrong in conventional, and whether it has got the same implications for Islamic economics.
Yes, absolutely. The West methodology, they borrowed from science, which is valid for material objects which obey laws and mathematical formulas. Human behavior is flexible, humans have free will, and therefore there is no formula which can predict human behavior. And the failure of mathematics to capture human behavior and the failure of any axiom to describe what you will do is well understood by both behavioral economists and many others. But the mainstream methodology is stuck, because, and that's why they have these things like the global financial crisis, which they cannot understand, because they axiomatize behavior and they make mathematical formulas for risk, and the global financial crisis did not fit that formula. Just like that, their formulas for human behavior do not fit human beings.
Thank you very much for your time, Professor. We welcome you to the 6th Islamic Workshop.
Thank you.